Hello everyone, in this video I will be discussing the Adams Farwell. But first, a bit of backstory about the company that created it. It started with the Roberts and Langworthy Iron Works, located in Dubuque, Iowa, and were manufacturers of fine light castings, such as grave markers and park benches. Eugene Adams invested in the company in June of 1883. When Roberts decided to retire, Adams took the position as the manager. The name changed to Langworthy and Adams Ironworks in 1885. When Langworthy retired in 1892, Eugene's brother Herbert bought Langworthy's share and the company was restructured as the Adams Company. But tragedy struck as the plant burnt down the same year in a disastrous fire. But the company reopened a new facility at East 4th Street, now making machine castings and household devices like a specialized heating vent and laundry stoves, to name a few. In 1895, Fay Oliver Farwell became manager of the company. Farwell had an infatuation with engines ever since he saw one demonstrated at the World's Fair and began experimenting with creating an internal combustion engine for an automobile. He designed a horizontally mounted rotary engine with three cylinders. The vertically standing crankshaft was fixed in the chassis and connected to a four-speed transmission. Farwell felt this configuration was lighter than conventional engines as it had no use for a flywheel, since the spinning engine crankcase and cylinders acted as a flywheel when running, nor had the use for a radiator because the engine cooled itself as it was spinning. Farwell completed the first prototype in 1898. It was basically a horse-drawn carriage. He mounted his engine between the front wheels. But this proved to be an impractical design, so his second car had the engine installed in the rear as all others would in the future. The Model 1 used bicycle wheels, but the next had wooden artillery wheels, which would then be used for all the other models. Little is known about car number 4, but was presumed to be similar to number 3. Car number 5 was shown at the Chicago Auto Show in February 1905. The first orders were now being taken. With only minor modifications, the car went into very limited production as the Model 6 2025 horsepower. Referring to its engine, Adams Farwell frequently used the slogan, "It spins like a top." Adams Farwell automobiles also had more unique details. The only available coachwork, called a convertible brougham, was in fact a town brougham, and the convertible part was not the top, but the driver's position. His bench seat in the front of the car was retractable and could fold away in bad weather, thus forming a splashboard. Then, the tiller and driving devices could easily be relocated in front of the rear seat under the fixed top. These cars could even have been started from the driver's seat as they provided a lever that had to be pulled up instead of the usual crank. It is this concept that leads to the claim that Adams Farwell automobiles were among the very first automobiles that could be driven year-round. This car was listed at $2,500, placing it in the lower part of the luxury car field. For 1906, the Model 6 became the Series 6, a new 5-cylinder rotary engine making 40-45 horsepower was added. The car got a longer wheelbase and a landaulette body style replaced the brougham. It was similar but had a convertible rear part of the top. They debuted a new version of the car as well. It was a touring car, frequently called a runabout. Both body styles were 5-seaters. 3 more cars were offered with the 40-45 horsepower engine only. One was an extended Brougham model, which had a longer wheelbase. The other, the Model 7A, was a seven-passenger Touring with a conventional-looking front end, though the engine was still in the rear. The rear seat was slightly moved forward. While standard wheelbase was 90 inches, the extended Brougham's was 94, and the 7A's was 108. All got the retractable front seat bench and the unique steering system. The third new car was very different from the rest. It was called the Model 8A Gentleman's Speed Roadster. It had a short wheelbase of 86 inches and the larger engine. Instead of using a body-on-frame setup as the previous cars, it utilized a unibody construction. This sports car was very fast for the time, with a top speed of around 75 miles per hour. Though it may have been hard to control at those speeds, and may not have had many places to do it at the time. The only remaining Adams Farwell automobile has a tag stating it was built by the Connolly Carriage and Buggy Company. It seems this company was reputed for building high-quality carriages and coachwork, but that they may have also built the chassis for the Adams Farwell as well. As some advertisements indicate that complete cars were offered, there is some evidence they might have built the bulk of the Adams Farwell bodies. For 1907, most models were gone, and Adams Farwell offered only an improved Model 7A Touring, now with an even longer wheelbase at 120 inches and a higher price of $3,250. Farwell had more ideas to offer. For 1908, a new Model 9 with a 50 horsepower engine appeared. This model is the first Adams Farwell to use a new 4-speed transmission, since most contemporary cars at the time only had 3 speeds. The new Adams Farwell offered an ingenious construction consisting of the transmission, 2 clutches, a lever for each of them, and 1 handle to operate the levers. 1 clutch engaged gears 2 and 4, the other gears 1 and 3, and reverse. So 2 speeds could be pre-selected, but the 1 handle operation prevented 2 speeds being engaged at the same time. The antiquated tiller steering had been replaced by a wheel, and there was a pedal for acceleration added as well. That meant that the removable steering was no longer an option and had to be removed, but they put the steering column and pedal on a rail system so that they could be moved from the left to the right, allowing the driver to sit on the left or right sides or in the middle of the car. The Model 9 came as 3 different models: the 7-passenger Touring, a 3-passenger coupe, and a 3-passenger roadster, the latter replacing the Model 8A, featuring a normal body-on-frame design. A final change came for 1909. The coupe was dropped, the roadster received 1 more seat, and the Touring became even longer with a 128-inch wheelbase. Adam Farwells were offered until around 1913. Then, production of automobiles ceased after just about 200 cars being built. Usually 25 cars per year left the factory, with 52 to 54 in 1910. A few of those went to the Dubuque Police Department. The Adams Company thought there was more money to be made by making custom-made gears and the like. They are actually still in business today, making custom-made gears and shafts. And that's about all there is to the Adams Farwell vehicles. I will leave you with a short video of one of their engines running. It is from the only surviving Adams Farwell left, a Model 6. I hope you learned something today. I know I did, researching this unusual but ingenious vehicle. I will see you in the next chapter. Have a good one.